Hello, my name is Carl. In this video, we are going to do the oil service for this BMW E90 M3. It is my first time to do the oil change at home, and it is going to be challenging because I have to lift the car up to drain the oil from the bottom. So please join me for learning how to use the trolley jack and the jack stands to lift the car. This is the jack points on the left-hand side. The rear and the front. Jack points on the right hand side, the rear and the front. We need four rubber plates at these jack points. Front jack point at a reinforcement strut. The jack point on the rear final drive. I'm using a trolley jack and four jack stands to raise the car. It is risky to get under the car that is floating in the air. Please do everything to protect yourself and your precious car. Safety first. Now I just try to lift the car from the front jack point with this super low extended jack. However, the arm of the jack is not that long enough that can reach under the car and reach the jack point. So I have to jack the car from the side and place a step on the front wheel, make a space here. Then we can make the jack go further in to reach the front jack point. Okay, ready to lift. This is the step I use and cast iron box for the water gauge. Okay, release the jack slowly. Okay, now we can jack the rear. Jack point at the rear axle final drive. It is not on the differential cover, but on the body. I place a brick and a piece of wood, so I hope that can reach the jack point on the rear differential. Let's do it carefully. Okay, we can lower the car slowly. Adjust the height that works best for you, and we can start the oil service. Let's follow the oil service instruction on the BMW manual. First, we will start with the oil filter. After we open the filter cap, the oil is going to spill, so place a rack so we don't make a mess. We are going to release this cap with a 36 millimeter socket. Take care of the oil. Look at that. Remove the old filter and the old ring. Also this one. The OEM oil filter is coming with new O-rings. And install the new filter. Okay, ready to go back in. On the oil filter cap, you will see the torque is 25 Newton meters. But later BMW published a service bulletin revising this tightening torque to be 40 Newton meters. So let's use a torque wrench to tighten the filter cap to its specified torque. It's a 40 Newton meter. Okay, that's done. Clean up the filter cap. Okay, now we can move on to drain the oil from the oil sump. Okay, now I'm under the reinforcement strut. The two drain plugs are here and here. We're going to release them with a 6mm hexagonal bit.
我要把机油接起来。好，你要去分析啊。对。你帮我看一下画面有没有这个东西。Here's
a tip for releasing the drain plugs. Use an extended hex bit. Turn the screw until you feel it is completely released. Hold the screw and stop the oil flow before you tilt the tool toward yourself and remove the screw. Then the oil flow will spill away from you. Besides, I collect the oil sample and send it to Blackstone Laboratory for engine wear analysis. The report will show metal composites in the engine oil and indicate the condition of the engine, especially the wearing of the rod bearings. The oil filter kit includes new copper washers for the drain plugs. Replace them and tighten the drain plugs to 25 Newton meter.
Okay, 那我们就把它锁上车。 机油滴到我的手了，我需要卫生纸。好，还有卫生纸吗？然后这样这边就好了，可以停止录影。
The oil spec required by BMW is 10W60, and the recommended brand is Castrol. There are tons of discussions about the alternative choices and viscosity and brands. Some people use 5W50 and even 0W40. I prefer the OE spec, but have to choose liquid moly this time just because Castrol is out of stock. And the oil quantity is 8.8 liter with filter change, or 8.4 liter without filter change. After the car is warmed up and the oil quantity is readable, top up the oil. Also, note that the indication will show change when more than 0.5 liter of oil is added in. After adding proper amount of engine oil and secured everything in the engine bay, we use ISTA to reset the CBS condition-based service reminder. Vehicle management, service function, maintenance and pre-delivery check, reset CBS condition-based service, reset CBS, okay, ABL, CBS reset KWP, display, please wait for the procedure, okay, R, set, please wait. Here we can see the CBS scope available in percentage and service counter. There has been 10 oil change. Select engine oil, continue, and yes, continue. Please wait, okay. The engine oil service has been set. And service function, continue, continue, okay. This is done, your car is good to go. You can reset the CBS reminder just by using the BC button. Switch on the ignition without starting the engine. Press and hold the odometer reset button down until you see the service reminder icon. Scroll down several times until you find the oil service icon. Press BC button to see the reset option. Hold the BC button until you see the mileage and the date for the next oil service. That's all for the engine oil service, but I still have to do the transmission oil service and the rear differential oil service since the car is already jacked up in the air. Please see my next video for more exercises under the car. Bye bye!